morning, students, and welcome to Students Faith Academy, Session 3. I hope you all are fine and doing well this morning. Let's do a quick recap of what we've learned in Session 1 and in Session 2. In Session 1 and 2, we've learned that Abram was called Abraham, and we see his lineage. We then go on to see that he was a man of excellence. We then move on and see Abraham's migration to Canaan and then how the Lord leads him to the promised land. We also see the conflict between Lot, that is Abraham's nephew, and the men of Abraham. We also see the chosen covenant that the Lord promised to Abraham and his descendants. We then go to see the fulfillment of this promise, that is, Sarah, Abraham's wife, gives birth to Isaac.
Let us observe this image. Image 1. Do you know which cities are burning and are on fire? Do you know how these cities were destroyed? Do you think destruction like this is caused because of a small reason? In image 2, do you recognize who this man is? This man is Abraham. Think about what Abraham is doing here. Is this something what you and I do? Children, I want you to think of these answers as we journey through this lesson. And we will see what God reveals about himself through these images.
In this short video that you will be shortly seeing, you will understand the sequence of events. Now, let us watch the video.
Welcome, Lord. Please, join me. Bring water, prepare food for our visitors.
Yes,
have you traveled far?
Yes, a long way. Abraham, where is your wife?
In there.
Next year, Sarah will have a son. Why do you laugh?
I didn't laugh.
You did. And when you have a son, you will name him Isaac, which means laughter.
Thank you for your hospitality. We must go.
Can I help you on your way? Where are you going?
To decide the fate of Sodom.
Mm-hmm.
Sodom has become corrupt, a city of sin.
But my nephew Lot lives there. He has a family.
The outcry against Sodom is great. Its sins are very grave.
You're going to destroy it. The whole city. You are a just God. Will you destroy the good men along with the evil ones?
Please! Help! Help us! Help!
What if there were 50 good people in Sodom? Will they suffer the same fate as the wicked?
Please! Help us!
We will test them. If my angels find 50 righteous people in Sodom, I will spare the whole city.
Please, help us. Help us.
Fewer. 30. 20. You would not destroy them, surely.
Please.
Down there!
Help us. This way.
What if there were 10 righteous men in Sodom? Would you not save them?
Lot, what are you doing? Who are these people?
They need our help. I'll do what I can for you.
Even if I find only 10, I will save the whole city.
This way!
What's that?
Open the door! Give us the strangers!
Take them out!
They are guests in my house.
Let us pass!
Let them be!
Take you to them!
The Lord is saving you.
Keep moving. That's it.
Abraham.
You are safe now. You must get away. The city is being punished.
Kimberly, come on! Kimberly!
Look back at the city of sin.
Okay.
Believe in God. Do not look back. God.
Is turned into a pillar of salt for disobeying God. Lot and his daughters flee to the mountains, never to see Abraham again.
Children, as you know, Sodom was one of the most ancient cities of Syria. We see how the city of Sodom and Gomorrah is destroyed because of their sin. Now, I want you to recollect, what was the sin that the Sodomites committed that the entire city was on fire? The cities were destroyed because of the Sodomites, as they were engaging in sexual relations with the same gender, which is called homosexuality. What is homosexuality? Homosexuality is not of godly type behavior. God made man and woman so that they can become one and produce many children and generations would follow. However, with homosexuality, two people of the same gender cannot get married or be in a relationship with each other. Hence, because of their sins, the entire city was punished. Now, let us see how God tests Abraham.
Let me make you some breakfast, Isaac.
After years of struggle, Abraham has learned that to be chosen by God is a blessing and a test. He must prove his faith again and again.
Sacrifice. No. No. Have I not shown you enough faith? Isaac.
Eat up. When you have children of your own, you'll want them to grow up as big and Abraham. What's the matter?
God wants a sacrifice. My boy, come with me.
Thank you. Father. We have the firewood, but where's the lamb?
The Lord will provide a sacrifice, my son.
Did Abraham take a lamb?
No, mistress. Bring the wood.
Father!
Isaac, you must trust in God. Abraham! A sacrifice? Oh, my boy, my boy, my boy.
God tests Abraham by asking him to sacrifice his only son Isaac at Mount Moriah. We see God's faithfulness in moments of trials. As Abraham spotted a small ram to be sacrificed instead of Isaac, on the altar he prepared.
We also see that Abraham intercedes with God on behalf of the people. God said to Abraham, "If I find 10 just people, I will save the entire city." But sadly, he didn't even find one. We see God's faithfulness in moments of trial when Abraham had to sacrifice his son Isaac. We see how God's faithfulness in this moment of trial helped him. He did not even say, "Why, Lord," or questioned anything. He was ready to sacrifice his only son Isaac. And there we see the mercy of God on Abraham and his son Isaac. For you and me, it is easy to conclude that God was very hard on Abraham. But we do not know his will for Abraham. But what we can take out of this is Abraham only and solely depended on God for everything that he did in his life. He trusted and followed the will of God. And so, today, we should also seek for the will of God in our lives. As we enter into the time of understanding the Word, I request you all to take a position that is comfortable. I want you all to reflect on the entire narrative that you all have seen so far. Please close your eyes and join your hands while we reflect on what we have learned today. As we've closed our eyes and have become aware of how Abraham discovers so much about God's goodness, let us listen to his encounters with God in the chapter Genesis 18, 22 to 33. So the men turned from there and went towards Sodom. While Abraham remained standing before the Lord, then Abraham came near and said, "Will you indeed sweep away the righteous with the wicked? Suppose there are 50 righteous within the city. Will you then sweep away the place and not forgive it for the 50 righteous who are in it? Far be it from you to do such a thing, to slay the righteous fair as the wicked. Far be that from you. Shall not the judge of all the earth do what is just?" And the Lord said, "If I find at Sodom 50 righteous in the city, I will forgive the whole place for their sake." Abraham answered, "Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord, I who am but dust and ashes. Suppose 5 of the 50 righteous are lacking, will you destroy the whole city for the lack of 5? And he said, "I will not destroy it if I find 45 there." Again he spoke to him, "Suppose 40 are found there," he answered, "for the sake of 40, I will not do it." Then he said, "Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak. Suppose 30 are found there," he answered, "I will not do it if I find 30 there." He said, "Let me take it upon myself to speak to the Lord." "Suppose 20 are found there," he answered, "for the sake of 20, I will not destroy it." Then he said, "Oh, do not let the Lord be angry if I speak just once more. Suppose 10 are found there," he answered, "for the sake of 10, I will not destroy it." And the Lord went his way when he had finished speaking to Abraham, and Abraham returned to his place. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let us contemplate on the verse that we just heard. Let's understand. Abraham is happy that God would have saved Sodom and Gomorrah if he had found even 10 people, 10 good people. He is also happy that he saved his son Isaac, who he thought had to be sacrificed. Abraham is surely thankful to Yahweh for having begun this relationship with him. We who have Abraham as our father in faith are happy to know these beautiful qualities of our God. We pray to him to allow us to go through a variety of experiences through which we come to know him and trust in him. In a special way, we pray for the uncertainty around us. In these times of the pandemic, we do not know what tomorrow holds for us. But we learn that we can be like Abraham, to trust in God, to trust in God's holy will in our life. Let us look at Abraham and see the bigger picture of his life. Let us ask God to show his will in times of uncertainty, in times where we do not know what the future holds for us. I pray that this wonderful narrative of Abraham and Abraham's life shows y'all how God can guide you even in the smallest areas of your life, be it online studying or even learning Sunday school online. Remember that the Lord is with you. I make this prayer in your holy name, Lord. Amen. Let us now listen to a beautiful hymn, God Will Make a Way Where There Seems to Be No Way, and relate to it how in Abraham's life, God did make a way where there seemed to be no way.
God will make a way where there seems to be no way. He works in ways we cannot see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to his side. With love and strength for each new day, he will make a way. He will make a see. He will make a way for me. He will be my guide. Hold me closely to his side. With love and strength for each new day, he will make a way.
Recall the questions I placed on the screen at the beginning of the class. Were you able to find appropriate answers for the same? In image 1, the first question was, do you know which cities are burning and are on fire? The answer is, the cities that are burning in the image is Sodom and Gomorrah. Question 2. Do you know how these cities were destroyed? The cities were destroyed because of their sins. Do you think destruction like this is caused because of a small reason? The answer? No, destruction like this is caused because the Sodomites went against the will of God by doing unholy things which were not of the kingdom of God. Let's see image 2. Do you recognize who this man is? The answer, the man is none other than Abraham. Question 2. Think about what Abraham is doing here. Abraham is sacrificing his son Isaac at Mount Moriah. Having got the answers of all the questions you were asked in the beginning of the class, let us now watch the story of a father and a daughter, which will remind you of Abraham's trust in God.
The narrative is about a father and a daughter. The father and the daughter used to often visit their grandmother, who would live across the river. They would have to cross a bridge to reach the other side of the river. However, this one day, the daughter was very scared and afraid. The father was wondering, why are you so scared and afraid to cross the bridge when we do this on a very regular basis? The daughter said, no, Daddy, it's raining really heavily and I am really, really scared. The father said, all right then, you hold on to my hand. The daughter quickly replied, no, no, Daddy, you hold on to my hand. The father was a little worried and wondering, what's wrong with my daughter? Why is she saying something like that? Then he asked her, daughter, isn't it the same if I hold your hand or you hold my hand? She said, no, Daddy, it is not the same. If I hold on to your hand, there is a chance of my hand slipping. However, if you hold on to my hand, I know that nothing will happen to me and we will reach the other side of the bridge safely without me falling into the river. In this small narrative, we understand that the girl has immense trust on her father. Similarly, how Abraham learns to trust God. It's activity time, kids. Here is an activity that you'll need to answer and send it to me before next Sunday so I can mark your presence for this class. Enjoy this class today. I'll see y'all next Sunday. Bye.